Welcome everyone to Junos with Just Commentary. So we're gonna react to part two, of course, of Hitler. That is an interesting video. I had no idea that Hitler went through so much as a young person, as a child. You know, he went through a lot, and somehow we always wonder, or I always wonder, you know, like why he was doing what he did. You know what I mean? And now I'm very happy that I've been exposed to this video. Kind of gives an idea of what happened or what led to him doing what he's doing. So now we're getting back to part two. Of course, I'm going to learn a lot more. Thank you so very much. Let's go ahead. Part two, of course.
Part Since two. Germany's military had to be reduced, Hitler could no longer remain a soldier after the war. But he kept working for the army as an informant.
Ooh.
After the war, communists in Germany had attempted a revolution, and the government was worried about communism in general. So Ooh. Hitler was tasked with infiltrating and reporting Top on secret? Any new political parties that could pose a communist
I guess
threat.
All secret spelling.
A new party called the German Workers' Party threw up a whole bunch of red
German
flags, so Hitler went along to one of their meetings, but found that they weren't communist at all. They were extreme right and shared many of his extreme beliefs, so
wow.
he left the army and signed up to join the party. His fantastic speaking abilities impressed the party's leadership and supporters, and he very quickly rose to the top. He
wow.
decided the party needed a makeover, so he renamed it to the National Socialist German Workers' Party, or Nazi
wow.
for short, and
Nazi.
He gave it a new color scheme.
That's where it came from!
The Nazis weren't very specific on policy, but Hitler made extravagant promises to return Germany to its former glory by undoing the Treaty of Versailles and reuniting all ethnic Germans into one nation. He also said
wow.
that only pure Aryan people should be allowed to be citizens, and that all Jews would lose their citizenship.
Oh, shoot.
These
so
ideas were
how...
already common in extreme right politics, but what set the Nazis apart was Hitler himself, and they quickly became the leading party on the extreme right. Many of the political parties in Germany at the time had paramilitary wings, and the Nazis were no different. Hitler set up the very descriptive Whole Protection Detachment, later changed to the very delightful Gymnastic and Sports Division,
what?
And finally settling on the ominous Storm Detachment,
what?
Or SA for short.
That escalated
Their
quickly.
Job was to defend Nazi party meetings and intimidate political opponents. And they would frequently engage in battles with communists on the streets. Since the Allies had demanded a reduction in Germany's military size, many trained soldiers were left unemployed. They liked the Nazi ideology, and it was only natural for them to join the SA, which grew larger and larger over time.
Oh my gosh.
The new democratic government that formed after World War I was pretty weak and ineffective. In order to pay reparations to the Allies, it started printing more money. The problem is that printing money doesn't actually give a country
Not at
more
all.
Money. It just makes
Mm-mm.
money less valuable. So
that
as the
is
country
true.
Printed more and more money, it became worth less and
uh-huh.
less, and the currency crashed.
Uh-huh.
In 1919, one US dollar was worth about 4 German marks. By December 1923, one US dollar was equal to 4.2 trillion marks.
Dang!
The price of bread rose to 200 billion marks. Banknotes became worthless. Unsurprisingly, in such an economic crisis, Germany struggled to pay the Allies.
Oh my
the
gosh.
French were pissed about this, so they occupied the Ruhr, an area full of factories, and took the economic output from the area as payment. They treated the German
oh,
civilians badly, and in total, approximately 130 Germans were killed during the occupation. Germans were furious, and Hitler and the Nazis thought that now would be a great time to lead a revolution. In November 1923, inspired by something a certain bold Italian man did a year earlier, Hitler stormed a meeting at a beer hall and called for an uprising against the government. With his supporters, he marched on the streets
wow.
of Munich, hoping the police would join his side. They did not.
Oh, shoot, war.
Hitler was put on trial for treason. He could have been sentenced to life, but the right-wing judges thought he was a pretty cool guy. Hitler knew the judges and knew that they would be lenient, so he took the opportunity to make impassioned speeches during the trial. And in the end, he was sentenced to just 5 years in prison,
oh
which
my
only
gosh,
served 9 months. And when I say prison, it was more like a pleasant hotel stay where he had plenty of time to write a book. The whole affair
oh
was
God.
Covered by the media nationwide, and it made Hitler famous. Hitler and his extreme message were now known throughout Germany, but the everyday German still didn't care much for him. In the 1928 election, the Nazis only won about 2% of the vote.
Ooh.
Many were still intimidated by all the violence and the shouting and how unpolitician-like he was, but
Ooh,
a new
boy.
Economic crisis would change all of that. To help Germany pay its reparations, America agreed to give it loans. In October 1929, the Wall Street crash happened, and America wanted its money back.
Oh.
The economic strain this put on an already struggling Germany was severe.
Dang.
Unemployment skyrocketed, poverty was widespread, and Germans were sick of it. It was clear that the newly formed democracy wasn't working.
Oh,
in the face
gosh.
Of crisis, Germans began
Who's
moving
to
the political extremes. If you were
oh.
German and wanted change, your choices
Hitler.
Now were either the communists or the Nazis. Hitler claimed that he was the only one who could return Germany to its former glory. The Nazi party used propaganda to make Hitler seem like a great and powerful man, and they gave the German people a scapegoat to blame for all their suffering. The promise of a single strong dictator was a breath of fresh air for Germans after years of failing democracy. Some bought into his extreme ideology, Some didn't agree with the racism, but were willing to vote for him anyway. Many didn't know much about politics at all, but just got caught up in the hype. Election after election, the Nazis became more and more popular, until in 1932, they became the biggest party in the German parliament. Hitler came to truly believe that he was some sort of great, destined savior of Germany.
Really?
He turned megalomaniac. He decided to run for president, and did surprisingly well, but still lost to the extremely popular World War I general, Paul von Hindenburg. Since he was now the leader of the biggest party, though, he demanded President Hindenburg make him chancellor. But Hindenburg was reluctant, seeing that Hitler was clearly such a big racist. Nazi leaders urged Hindenburg to give Hitler the chancellorship, fearing the rising support for communism, and leader of the center party, von Papen, who had been secretly negotiating with Hitler, said to Hindenburg, "How about we make Hitler chancellor on the condition that I get to be vice chancellor and most government jobs go to us moderate conservatives?
Huh.
That way, I'll get to keep my power. I mean, we'll get to keep our power and we'll control Hitler like he's our angry little puppet. What could possibly go wrong?"
As it turned out,
everything. Hitler became chancellor of Germany in January 1933, but he was not yet a dictator. In February, the German parliament building was set on fire. Historians still aren't sure who did it, and many suspect the Nazis did it themselves, but Hitler blamed the communists, and he convinced President Hindenburg to sign an emergency decree allowing him to imprison all communists and other political opponents. Communists and others were sent off to the first concentration camp in Dachau. At this time, the elderly President Hindenburg passed away, giving Hitler the perfect opportunity. He introduced a law to Parliament that would allow him to make all future laws and decisions entirely on his own. With his political opponents in prison and the SA intimidating others, Hitler's law passed. Just 2 months after becoming Chancellor, Hitler was now a dictator. He still had one problem. The leader of the SA wanted the SA to take over the job of the regular German army, and the German army didn't like that idea. Hitler needed to maintain the support of his professionally trained German army, more so than his rough and rowdy SA. So one night in June 1934, he had Rom and many other of his own SA officers rounded up and murdered. While he was at it, he took the opportunity to brutally settle some personal scores as well. Politicians who had disagreed with him in the past, reporters who had printed negative articles about him.
This guy just went
absolutely nothing, but they thought he was someone else. In some cases, even their families were murdered. In total, up to 200 people were killed in what became known as the Night of the Long Knives.
What?
The army, now satisfied that they wouldn't be replaced, pledged total allegiance to their new Führer, and Hitler's control was now absolute. Life in Germany changed violently. Freedom of the press, expression, and public assembly were suspended. Jews were initially branded and their businesses boycotted. And eventually, Hitler would go on to have 6 million Jewish men, women, and children killed in concentration camps. Hundreds of thousands of people were forced into sterilization for physical and mental imperfections. The Hitler Youth became a way to brainwash the young. Boys were trained to fight and returned home from camp violent. Girls were told their purpose was to have many pure Aryan children, and they would sometimes return from camp pregnant. When their parents were understandably horrified, their children would threaten to turn them over to the Gestapo for standing in the way of Germany's greatness.
The
standard greeting changed, and you could be sent to a concentration camp for not using it. This way, it seemed like everyone was a Nazi supporter. If you dared oppose Hitler or speak out against him in any way, you also would be sent to a concentration camp.
Jeez.
German nationalism captivated the
young
adult.
We have to appreciate
extreme
what
ideology
we have, you know.
And anti-Semitism festered in him
things
as
like
a young
that.
Man
really
living
see,
a hard life on the streets.
Really
Germany's defeat in the First World War filled him with hatred and a thirst for vengeance. A political movement that treated him like a god, and hundreds of thousands looking up to him as their savior, made him a megalomaniac. And soon, his aggressive foreign policies would drag the world into a second tragic global conflict.
Wow.
Otherwise known as
World War II. By the way, I've got to react to his videos. I got requests. Yeah, I'm gonna react to it. I got requests for World War II. World War II Part 1, World War II Part 2. So many requests for Oversimplified suddenly just started pouring in. Wow, okay guys, so that is the craziness of how Hitler came into existence, how Hitler became how he became. As I said, part one, the child was traumatized. He was traumatized. Wow, so all of this, he didn't just get up one day and say, I don't like Jews. No, all these things he went through his life led to the situation, bam. So that is, it's actually amazing learning about this. I'm kudos to Oversimplified, of course. The YouTube channel, the link is in the description. for producing such a video, for giving such information out to the world to explain the situation. So that persons, it's not just about having a hatred for Hitler. Again, I heard of Hitler. I don't want to say what I heard and what I mean, because I don't want to say the wrong thing. And it's a trouble on my head. So I would simply say this exposed a lot of new truth and a lot of new information in regards to Hitler and his life. And I'm not saying that I'm sympathetic to Hitler, but I understand what led to his crazy ways. Okay, thank you so very much for requesting, guys. Don't forget to subscribe to Junos with Just Commentary, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter. If you want me to react to video, please leave a comment below. Thank you so very much. Bye, guys.